Halo teman-teman, salam jumpa lagi di Layman English Solution. Pagi, siang, atau sore, atau malam ini fokus di talking about daily in office. Jadi ngobrol kegiatan keseharian di kantor. Oke ya. Seperti biasa ngobrolnya ngalur ngidul sana kesini, tapi bahasa Inggrisnya keren, bahasa Inggris standar ini. Ya, kalau teman-teman ini saran nih teman-teman ya. Coba deh latihan sendiri otodidak, ya nanya sendiri jawab sendiri itu lebih efektif. Ya, kalau nungguin teman lagi ya boleh lebih dua ya nggak masalah. Jadi program saya ini bisa berlatih sendiri bisa berdua. Menurut saya saran saya kalau memang belum ada teman latihan aja sendiri, nanya sendiri jawab sendiri coba deh. Ya tiru aja pronunciation-nya ini. Oke saya mulai nih jadi pelan-pelan ya. Shinjiku, I'm going to go to my office now. Do you want to go to your office by car or by bus? I'm going to go to my office now. Kamu mau pergi kantor sekarang? Do you want to go to your office by bus or by car? Sorry. Do you want to go to your office by car or by bus? Kamu pergi kantor naik mobil sendiri atau naik bis? Yes, I do. I want to travel by private car. Yes, I do. I want to travel by private car. Ya, aku mau berangkat naik mobil sendiri gitu. Do you come there in time or on time? Do you come there in time or on time? Apakah kamu kalau tiba di sana, nyampe di sana itu lebih dulu atau tepat waktu? Yes, I always come there in time, bro. Gak pakai yes juga gak apa-apa nih. Yes, I do, boleh. Yes, I always come there in time, bro. Ya, yeah, saya selalu datang ke sana lebih awal, bro. Yes, I always come there in time, bro. Can you tell me whether your location office far or near from here? Can you tell me whether your location office far or near from here? Can you tell me whether your location office far or near from here? Kasih tahu apakah lokasi kantor kamu ini jauh atau dekat sih dari sini, itu bahasa gaulnya gitu. I think that the location office is not far from here. I think that the location office is not far from here. Kok pikir sih lokasi kantor gua enggak jauh kok dari sini itu. Tidak jauh dari sini. Yeah, I think that the location office is not far from here. What time do you usually leave to your office every day? What time do you usually leave to your office every day? Biasanya kamu berada di kantor jam berapa tiap hari gitu. I usually leave to my office at 6:15 a.m. I usually leave to my office at 6:15 a.m. Gue biasanya berangkat jam 6:15 gitu. How long do you actually need the time to go to your office every day? How long do you actually need the time to go to your office every day? Berapa lama sih lo butuh waktu nyampe di kantor setiap hari? Gitu. I need 28 minutes going to be there. I need 28 minutes going to be there. Gue butuh 28 menit nyampe di sana. Gitu. How much liter do you need gasoline arriving there? How much liter do you need gasoline arriving there? Berapa liter lu butuh bensin tuh nyampe di kantor gitu. Ya, namanya juga orang ngobrol ya. Ini kan nanti konteksnya bisa diganti, teman-teman. Ya, how much liter do you need gasoline arriving there? Berapa liter lu butuh bensin nyampe di kantor? I don't know it exactly, bro. Perhaps I need around a half liter petrol. Perhaps I need around a half liter petrol. I don't know it exactly, bro. Perhaps I need around a half liter petrol. Gue nggak tahu persisnya. Mungkin gue butuh setengah liter kali ya, gitu. Setengah liter nih, a half liter petrol. Petrol ini sama dengan gasoline. Ya. Is your occupation in your office as a manager or an employee? Is your occupation in your office as a manager or as an employee? Apakah jabatan kamu di kantor ini sebagai manajer atau apa karyawan biasa? Gitu. I'm a marketing manager. Saya seorang manager marketing. I am a marketing manager. I am a marketing manager. Are you really excited at your office surrounding? Are you really excited at your office surrounding? Kamu di lingkungan kantor menyenangkan nggak? Gitu. Are you really excited at your office surrounding? Menyenangkan nggak di lingkungan kantor? Yes, I think in my circumstance is nice. Yeah, I think in my circumstance it's nice. Ya, gue pikir di lingkungan kantor gue menyenangkan, enak gitu, gitu, ya kan? Excited sama circumstances sama surrounding ini sama nih, lingkungan. Excited itu menyenangkan kan gitu, nonverbal. What is your company's production at present? What is your company's production at present? Perusahaan kamu produksi apa nih saat ini? Gitu. The company produce the kids toy. The company produce the kids toy. Perusahaan memproduksi mainan anak-anak. Gitu gampangnya gitulah ya. The company produce the kids toy. Perusahaan kami, perusahaan itu memproduksi mainan anak-anak. How many does your company have employees? How many does your company have employees? Berapa banyak karyawan di perusahaan kamu sekarang? There are 18 employees including several managers. Ada 18 karyawan termasuk manager. Wow. Ini enggak besar berarti ya karyawan. There are 18 employees including several managers. Have you ever thought that you will resign from that office? Have you ever thought that you will resign from that office? Lu pernah enggak kepikiran mau resign dari kantor? No, I have never thought that I will permit with my director. No, I have never thought that I will permit with my director. Oh, enggak pernah sama sekali aku punya kepikiran mau resign dari perusahaan itu. No, I have never thought that I will permit with my director. Pakai pesan bevok, saya enggak pernah sama sekali kepikiran mau resign dari perusahaan. Have you worked more or less than 5 years there? Ini kan ngobrol seperti biasanya nih, kalau kita ketemu teman kan ngobrolnya seperti gini. Ya kan, enggak ngalor ngidul, keren pakai bahasa Inggris ini. Ya. Have you worked more or less than 5 years there? Lu udah bekerja di situ ada enggak 5 tahun gitu. Have you worked more or less than 5 years? Kurang lebih 5 tahun gitu. I have joined the company for 6 years. I have joined the company for 6 years. Gua udah kerja di situ selama 6 tahun, bro. Gitu. Yeah. Have you worked more or less than 5 years there? I've joined the company for 6 years. Oh, gitu. Di dialog nih, ngobrol nih. Have you been satisfied working as a marketing manager there? Have you been satisfied? Lu udah merasa puas ya? Enggak ada kata merasa. Jadi. Have you been satisfied working as a marketing manager there? Lu udah puas ya bekerja di sebagai marketing di sana? Yes, I have. I mean, I have been enjoyed working there for 6 years. Yes, I have. I mean, I've been enjoyed working there for 6 years. Yeah. Maksud gue nih, gue ada menyenangkan banget deh kerja di situ selama 6 tahun. Gitu. Has the company been there for years? Has the company been there for years? Apakah perusahaan kamu tuh udah 6 tahun, udah bertahun-tahun ya di situ? I think that the company has been there since 2008. I think that the company has been there since 2008. Kok pikir sih perusahaan gue kalau nggak saya berdiri sejak 2008 tuh, gitu. I think that the company has been there since 2008. Did you have a certain meeting with men or branch office last week? Oh, pindah lagi topiknya. Bukan pindah, ya topiknya udah badue lagi nih. Did you have a certain meeting with main or branch office last week? Lo minggu lalu ke kantor cabang atau kantor pusat ngadain meeting? Gitu. No, I didn't. I did it last month. No, I didn't. I did it last month. Begitu bahasa Inggris. Enggak. Gua ada meeting bulan lalu tuh. Gitu. I did it tuh. Ini did kata kerja di sini. Ini kata bantu. Nih. No, I didn't. I did it last month. Did you visit the meeting in out of or inside of the city? Did you visit the meeting in out of or inside of the city? Lu meetingnya di luar kota apa di dalam kota tuh bulan lalu? Gitu. Did you visit the meeting in out of or inside of the city? Jadi bahasanya, did you visit the meeting in out of, gitu, nyambung ya, in out of or inside of the city? I often visit the first and the last one in out of town. I often visit the first and the last one in out of town. Saya selalu sering yang pertama dan yang terakhir yang di luar provinsi itu gitu. What city did you join the meeting last week? What city did you join the meeting last week? Kota apa yang lo meeting di minggu lalu itu? Oh, bulan lalu harusnya ya, sorry. Last week I joined the meeting in out of province, bro. Last week I joined the meeting in out of province, bro. Minggu lalu, ya katakanlah nih minggu lalu lah ya. Gua meeting di luar provinsi. Waduh, jauh nih. Was the topic about financial report or monthly budgeting? Topik lo waktu meeting tuh keuangan atau budget? That was about monthly budgeting. Yes, I remember about it, bro. Masalah budgeting bulanan biasa itu. Ya, gue inget banget masalah minggu lalu. Yeah, that was about monthly budgeting. Yes, I remember about it, bro. How many times will you come to Brands or Main office in a month? How many times will you come to Brands or Main office in a month? Berapa kali kamu kalau kunjungan ke kantor cabang, kantor pusat dalam sebulan? If I'm not wrong, both of them are twice in a month. If I'm not wrong, both of them are twice in a month. Wah, kalau nggak salah sih, dua kali sebulan gitu. Will you go visiting some old or new customers in a month? Will you go visiting some old or new customers in a month? Lu mau kunjungan lagi ke pelanggan lama tahun baru nih? Pelanggan lama atau pelanggan yang baru dalam bulan ini? Yes, but it usually depends of the season of the last meeting, bro. Yeah, but it usually bergantung dari keputusan dari pertemuan terakhir, bro. What do you think if I say that the company where you have been working more than 5 years is an excellent prospect for you, brother? Agak cepat nih teman-teman nih. Yeah. What do you think if I say that the company where you have been working more than 5 years is excellent prospect for you, brother? Wow, thank you so much, bro. Means that I do agree about your estimation. By the way, thank you for talking of this morning, brother. Then I would like to permit with you, I mean, the time is coming to leave to the office. Thank you once again. See you, brother. Bye-bye. Wow. Agak cepat tadi itu ya, saya terjemahkan nih. Teman-teman bisa ngulang loh. But, gini. Yes, but it usually depends on the season of the last meeting. Biasanya sih bergantung dari pertemuan terakhir. What do you think if I say that the company where you have been working? Bagaimana menurut kamu kalau gue bilang nih perusahaan lo di mana tempat bekerja 5 tahun, wah prospeknya luar biasa nih, bagus banget nih. Ya, dia muji nih ceritanya, memuji ya, menyanjung. Lo setuju gak kalau gue bilang lo kerja di situ prospek nih? Bilang begitu loh. Jarang kan teman bilang begitu. Wow, thank you so much bro. Makasih banyak bro estimasinya. Gue setuju banget deh. Gitu. By the way, thank you for talking this morning, brother. Makasih nih ngobrol di sini. Then I would like to meet with you. Gue mau pamitan sekali nih. I mean, the time is coming to leave to the office. Ini waktunya udah berada kantor nih. Oke, ketemu lagi. Bye-bye. Gitu, teman-teman. Luar biasa ya dialog panjang. Jadi teman-teman bisa ulang lagi tuh. Ya, ulang lagi gitu. Nah, saya gak perlu bahas. Jadi bukan gak perlu bahas. Jadi dalam dialog ini tensisnya lengkap banget ya kan. Ada present tense. Ini kan present tense. Kalau diterjemahin gaul kan begini kan. Gue berada kantor sekarang. Gue kantor naik mobil habis gitu. Enggak, gue naik mobil. Kan begitu orang dialog bahasa Indonesia kan begitu. Ini bahasa Inggrisnya keren. Sekarang saya baca lagi tanpa interupsi nih ya, biar diulang-ulang nih. Nanti teman-teman bisa ngulang lagi tuh. Oke ya, tanpa terjemahan tapi ini. Jadi waktu saya baca begini, I'm going to go to my office now. Nah, teman-teman tuh udah harus bisa menerjemahkan gitu. Belajar harus begitu. Jadi udah langsung, I'm going to go to my office now. Gue berangkat kantor, begitu. Jadi dalam hati tuh harus cepat. Begitulah latihan bahasa Inggris, saya juga begitu dulu. Sekaligus nambah kosakata, ya kan? Kayak ini tanpa terjemahan, cuma diulang. Jadi ini programnya reading, reading tapi dibuat praktek gitu ya. Sejiko biasa nih. I'm going to go to my office now. Do you want to go to your office by car or by bus? Yes, I do. I want to travel by private car. Do you come there in time or on time? Yes, I always come there in time, bro. Can you tell me whether your location office far or near from here? I think that the location office is not far from here. What time do you usually leave to your office every day? I usually leave to my office at 6:15 p.m. How long do you actually need the time to go to your office every day? I need 28 minutes going to be there. How much liter do you need gasoline arriving there? I don't know it exactly, bro. Perhaps I need around a half liter petrol. Is your occupation in your office as a manager or as an employee? Is your occupation in your office as manager or as an employee? I'm a marketing manager. Wow, see. Are you really excited at your office surrounding? Yes, I think in my circumstance it's nice. What is your company's production at present? The company produces the kid toys. How many does your company have employees? There are 18 employees, including several managers. Have you ever thought that you will resign from that office? No, I have never thought that I will permit with my director. Have you worked it more or less than 5 years there? I have joined the company for 6 years. Have you been satisfied working as a marketing manager there? Yes, I have. I mean, I've been enjoying working there for 6 years. Has the company been there for years? I think that the company has been there since 2008. Did you have a certain meeting with Man or Brand's office last week? No, I didn't. I did it last month. Did you visit the meeting inside of the city? I often visit the first and the last one in out of town. What city did you join the meeting last week? Last week, I joined the meeting in out of province, bro. What was the topic about financial report or monthly budgeting? That was about monthly budgeting. Yes, I remember about it, bro. How many times will you come to Brands or Main office in a month? If I am not wrong, both of them are twice in a month. Will you go visiting some old or new customers in a month? Yes, but it usually depends on the season of the last meeting, bro. What do you think if I said that the company where you have been working for 5 years, excellent prospect for you, brother? Wow, thank you so much, bro. Means that I do agree about your estimation. By the way, thank you for talking of this morning, brother. Then I would like to permit with you. I mean, the time is coming to leave to the office. Thank you once again. See you, brother. Bye-bye. Itu, teman-teman. Ya, saya kira cukup jelas ini terbukti dalam dialog panjang seperti ini. Tensinya nggak selalu 5, nggak selalu 4, bisa 2, bisa 1. Diulang lagi aja, teman-teman. Jadi, tolong dibagikan, teman-teman, yang ini. Mohon maaf nih, saya ini nggak bosan-bosan ya menyampaikan ini begini. Jadi, ketika teman-teman udah lama ya kepingin belajar bahasa Inggris, ini cara yang paling benar menurut saya. Gak ada cara lain. Ini cara. Kalau selama ini kan teman-teman kan hanya hafalan. Hafalan bukan kalimat yang dibutuhkan kan gitu. Kalau ini kan langsung matang udah, langsung dihafal aja. Kasarnya begini deh, saya kasih pandangan. Dibaca aja setiap kali. Seminggu tiap hari aja dibaca sambil dipahami. Coba deh. Ya pastinya sambil dipahami. Kalau ini present tense, kalau ini auxiliary, kalau ini yang begini ini past tense. Dominan present tense ini, percakapan ini. Memang dominan present tense. Ini udah internasional. Hanya konteksnya aja jadi bisa diganti gitu. Jadi sekali lagi, latihan sendiri lebih efektif. Berdua ya gak apa-apa juga. Sendiri, ngomong sendiri, jawab sendiri. Kan efektif itu. Coba deh. Ya, jangan lagi komplain terus. Gak ada bahasa Inggris yang ini lebih baik daripada yang itu. Gak ada. Bahasa Inggris itu sama baiknya. Sama dua-duanya nanti teman-teman tahu sendiri bedanya itu. Antara British dan American English itu tahu bedanya. Gitu. Oke ya teman-teman. Jadi sekali lagi latihan sendiri bisa. Latihan berdua juga lebih bisa juga gitu. Terus jangan latihan cuma seminggu sekali, terus gimana coba? Apa sih tujuan pentingnya di sini? Otomatis pronunciation-nya nambah. Pengkayaan pronunciation kan nambah ini otomatis pronunciation-nya saya bagi-bagi ini. Segini banyaknya. Kosakata juga langsung nambah ini, teman-teman. Iya kan? Yuk, tulisannya occupation, bahasanya gimana kalau kita nggak biasa? Your occupation, udah saya bantu. Tulisannya really excited tulisannya. Bahasanya gimana coba? Are you really excited tuh? Kan udah terbantukan. Enggak perlu lihat kamus lagi gitu ya. The company tulisannya company. Bahasanya the company produce the kids toy tuh begitu. Ya, tulisannya employees. Bahasanya gimana? Employees tuh begitu, including. Kan semua saya bantu, jadi teman-teman ini udah matang nih, udah tinggal ngulang lagi, dengerin, ya kan? Gak ada lagi nih, ya kalau dikatakan sempurna ya jangan bilang sempurna. Kalau menurut saya ini latihan bahasa Inggris. Oke teman-teman, tolong dibagikan dengan tetangga atau siapa aja lah yang memang ingin belajar bahasa Inggris dari sini dulu. Jangan lihat temanya, temanya bisa diganti nanti. Jadi fokuskan ke subjek, predikat, objek. Ini semua udah terjawab ya. Ada subjek, predikat, standar SPOK, kalimat sederhana, ada verbal, non-verbal, ada tensisnya 4. Selesai. Cuma segitu teman-teman. Oke, mohon maaf kurang lebihnya. Selamat berlatih, dan terus berlatih. Bye-bye.